Erev Shabbos Veshchedesh, Menachem Av, beginning a new Masechta Sukkah, which will take us to Tishrei, and definitely finish within the Shleishim Yom Kedem Machag. So we will appreciate Sukkah this year, something extraordinary. Okay, we start the Mishnah, Sukkah, Shehi Gevoya, Lemailim, Esimama. A Sukkah which is higher than 20 Amos. Psula, it is possible. A sukkah which is higher than 20 amos is possible. Number one. Rabbi Huda disagrees. Machshir, Rabbi Huda holds a sukkah above 20 amos is kosher, as the Gemara will explain. That's din number one. Din number two. She'ena gavoya asara tvachim. The Gemara sukkah is divided into two parts. The first half of sukkah is all about the sukkahs. The second half is all about lulav and arba minim. So a sukkah, if it's not 10 tvachim high, also it is possible. Why some of the shame hold is not if it's possible below 10 tvachim is because it's not a roof, so it's not a schach, it's not a sukkah. Usha ain lo gimot fanus, if it has no three walls, if it's less than, and we'll see the Gemara later, how do we know three walls? And number four is usha chamasa meruba mitzilasa, if there is more sun than shade, it is possible. Why is it possible more? So the Gemara later will say we're talking about the ground. That if on the ground there's more sun than shade, which means that means that if it's down here, there's more sun than shade, then the schach must be equal amounts. And we need more shade than sun. So and Rashi says that therefore, because the shade is mute, it is totally bottled as if it's non-existent. He's talking about what hits the ground. Rashi says over here that why is a sukkah called a sukkah? Al shem schach kodesh sukkah. Because the main part of a sukkah is the schach, and that's where the name sukkah comes from. Okay, says the Gemara. Let's go through each bit. First of all, Tanan, so we learned over there, Movi Shukavoya Mesimama, a Movi that's higher than 20 Amma, Yemayat. A Movi that's higher than 20 Amma, you should buy. We learned in Erevin not that long ago. If you have a Movi, so you have all these Chatzeris that spill onto a side street, has three walls, and then from there it spills onto a Shusarabin. If the fourth side is totally exposed, we need to do something on the fourth side. So by a Movi, what do? On the fourth side, we put in a pillar going across or a post. It's called a lechi, or we do a kaira on top. And there the Gemara says that if the beam going across is above 20 amos, lower the height. So why by sukkah does it say if it's above 20, it just says it's disqualified, puzzle. We're up to the Gemara and the Bezam and Aleph, just right where the Gemara begins. So Tanan Hassam, how come over here by a sukkah if it's above 20 amos? You tell me if the schach is above 20 amos, it's puzzle. And by Movi, there's very the same idea. And there it gives you an eight to how to rectify it. Tanan Hassam, if it's higher than 20 amos, he might reduce it. W-Huda says, ain't it, so you don't have to. Same argument as we have here. So Maishna Gabi Sukkah, why by Sukkah the Tani Zatzula is disqualified? Maishna Gabi Mavi, why by Mavi the Tani Takanta? It tells you a remedy. The Mavi gives two answers. Answer number one, Sukkah the Raisa, Sukkah, which is Mahatayra, the din of 20 Amas, we learn from the Torah. Even before the Mishnah was written, that din already existed, that it's possible, that it's not good. Tani, therefore, Zatzula, therefore, the Mishnah says, he didn't follow what the Torah says, possible. Abamavi, why a sukkah above 20 amos? This chach is no good. We'll soon see more three reasons. So four reasons. Mavi, when it comes to a street, that mission is the one that teaches us a din in the first place that you even have to have a beam. So how can you tell your apostle when we don't even know you? It's telling you the din of having a beam going across to remind you that the mavi is coming to an end. It's not parashas rabim. Mavi rabbanu, turn to counter. It gives you a remedy. The boy say, another way of looking at it is. That's how Rashi learns. Even you also learn a remedy how to fix it up. So how come by sukkah doesn't say pasha? Because the Pesach Mil said that too many psulim incorporate in this Mishnah. And if you're going to remedy each one, the Mishnah will become a very long Mishnah. Pasiv atanim psul. If it's very easy, just say we're pasled over. Mavli delay nafish mili. Mavli is only one halacha that about 20 amos. Here we have three walls. We have more sun than shade, and we have to have the minimum height as well. Too many dinim to tell you how to fix it up. But my mavli is only one din, a beam above 20 amos. Lay nafish mili. Tanik if it says takanta, it gives you the taskana. Oh, long enough as it is. Now, the whole idea of a mission is brevity, as Rashi says, teach people in a shorter way. But Tosfos learns, when it's the first answering matter is the Raisa Rabbanan means, the word Yemayet sounds like the Chatchila. But by the Ebed, it's all right. When you say psula, it means l'chatchila and by the Ebed. And therefore, when it comes to the Raisa, we wanted to make sure that everybody realizes it's not just l'chatchila, we want you to make sure the schach is below 10, you know, below 10, 20 amas. Even by the Ebed has to be below. Second more non-mili. So how do you know this dinner? But let's focus now on the 20 amas. How do you know? Later on, we'll focus on the other dinim. Amar Rabba Rabbas comes along the first one, Lama Cross, and the Pasik, Leman Yedu Deire Seichem. The Pasik says, you should know, Kibesukas Eshapti B'nei Yisrael. I want you to know. So what we're saying over here is that Rabba's learning, he's not talking about tell your children the story. He's telling you, sit in the Sukkah and you feel that this is part of the story. How do you feel? We look up at the schach, because the schach is the main part of the sukkah, and you feel like you're enclosed with schach, and therefore you remember the midst of sukkah. So add as imam of sukkah till 20 amas, you feel like you're sitting in the sukkah and you're covered in all sides. The mayim is on the ceiling. If the roof is above 20 amas, the schach above 20 amas, ain't nothing you should love a sukkah. You don't even feel it. Why? Should I show to bein? Your eyes don't even engage. Okay, that's Rabba. That's it. Fair enough. Okay, Rabzeda says, Mahocha, favor the following passage. Well, the Gemara will soon say why each one doesn't learn from the other ones. He says in the following passage, the Sukkah Tiel Etzel Yaimam, it said that the Sukkah should be, it says, the loss of love and she will come. The Sukkah will be for a shade, to provide shade during the day. It'll protect you also from the cold and from the winds and the rain. So add esim amma till 20 amas adam yeshay betzel sukkah. If the walls are up to 20 amas high and if it's sunny out there, it's the shade is being provided for inside the sukkah by the schach. If the schach is above 20 amas, then you're not getting the shade from the schach, you're getting the shade from the walls. Ain't nothing if shel sukkah ever so fun. The shame already asked, what about right in the middle of the day? Midday, the sun's right on top. So some of the shame answer, apart from this and Tisha, the sun is always on an angle. So even in the middle of the day, you're not going to get any sun if the sukkah is the minimum size, at 20 amas, 21 amas high, you're not going to get any sun, any shade from the schach. The shade will be only from the walls. If the problem is you're not getting, you have to get shade from the schach, what about you make a sukkah between two mountains, you build it between two houses, so you're not getting any shade from the schach because the walls upstanding there are providing you the shade. Okay, the sukkah called you, it says the sukkah teal tell you, you have to have the sukkah to protect you. She says to him, Omle Hassam over there, Dal Ashtaz Kanayim, he says over there that if you remove the something which is extraneous to the sukkah, you will get shade from the schach. Ikat sail sukkah. Hoch over here, Dal Defanas, even if you remove the walls of the sukkah, if the schach is above 20 amas, lekat sail sukkah. You're not getting any shade from the sukkah. That's answer number two. That's Rav Zeda. Rava says Mahacha from the following passage. Basukas Teishu Shivas Yamim says, Basukas, as you said, 7 days. Omra Tayyatari says, Kol Shivas Yamim. It says, this is how much time we learn. Build a sukkah that lasts for 7 days. That means something very temporal. So Omra Tayyatari, Kol Shivas Yamim, that during the 7 days, Tayyim Bididas Keva, leave your home, which is a permanent edifice, Vishav Bididas Ara, and live in a home, which is temporary. If the sukkah is under 20 amas, adam oisadirasei diras aray. You can build a temporary sukkah, makeshift sukkah, it'll last. If you want to build it above 20 amas, the structure requires something much more solid. Even though you made an aray, but generally speaking, people, when they build such a structure, are making it as keva, ain't adam oisadirasei diras aray, el diras keva. And because the Torah doesn't describe keva and what's considered aray, it says keva is an aray, the Torah is talking about size. Not materials or anything else like that. I'm going to buy a ass. So also, mechitza shel barzel. So what happened? You build a 10 amah high sukkah, but you made the wall solid out of metal. You said it has to be temporary. That's what I'm going to say. A person can build it temporary. Then, even if you built it permanently, you use rock wall, stone wall. Now, I mean, nothing. Generally, it's such a large structure, you're not going to build it temporary because it's not going to last very long. It'll tilt very easily. Even if you build it, you're not yitzer. Interesting. Abaye attacks Rava, Abaye attacks Zayda, and Abaye had respect for Zerba, but didn't ask the question. Now says the Gemara. Kulu, before you go back to it, Tesis wants to know here if a sukkah, even if it's below 20 amas, even if you build it, the structure in a kevadik way, you're not, it's not possible, right? It doesn't matter if you make it. So, just want to know, so what's wrong? We say that if it rains inside a sukkah, it's a simul kolola. Why can't we just nail in our roof? Make it keva. But you're just telling me right now, as long as you build it below 20 amas, I don't care if it's keva, the structure's keva now. So what's wrong? Yeah, I should ask, why not? So the first part of Tesis goes with the gang, and it's a big machlokes shayin. First part of the gang is, you know why you can't nail in a roof? Because only mid-rabbanan, we are worried, gzeidus tikkus bayis. That everyone agrees, it has to be a sukkah, not a house. Even if you hold it, a rabbi said, yeah, you could build a keva, but it can't be a house. Sukkah mid-rabbanan, the bayis, as we'll see later. So if you were, so the only reason why you can't nail down the schach, prevent the water from coming in, is because of mid-rabbanan, we are worried the next time you can sit in the house. That's one part of Tesis. Tesis, the answer Tesis says is no, and it's mahatreda, because since the sukkah is called, like Rashi says, why is it called sukkah? Shem's chach. Therefore, the other parts of the sukkah, if it's keva, we don't care. It's chach part, which it says, you know, it'll be a sukkah, not a bais. Since that's what a sukkah is, the chach mahatreda has to be aray. So even machlek is here whether mahatreda, the chach has to be aray or midraban. We'll see later in the gate to machlek to show him how thick you can make the chach if it rains high enough, but any time and all that. So just remember this face. It's very easy to get it. Take it further. Cool, look at Abba Amri. So how come not everyone agrees with Abba's reason of Laman Yedu? That Laman Yedu Dorisecha means not that you, while you're sitting in the sukkah, you have to realize that you're sitting in the sukkah and you have to engage. It means that you got to pass it on to your children. And what do you mean, Pastor? So Rashi says, what's it to pass on to children? So Rashi learns, you have to tell them about the Nani HaKavod, the miracle of Nani HaKavod. Seems to Rashi clearly, but if, like Rabbi Akiva that learns that the Inyo Sukkahs is because they built Sukkahs mamish, there's nothing to tell your children. That's what Rashi clearly says. Why get involved in the machlekes of whether it's a Nani HaKavod or Sukkahs mamish? Whatever it is, tell your children. Rashi says, no. Rashi says here, a few lines on the top. Hekif sukkahs anani akavod anasa lovers. You got to tell them the story, which would then mean, according to Rashi, that itself is the machlekes between Rabbah and everybody else. Rabbah paskas like Rabbi Akiva that it's only sukkahs mamish if there's nothing to tell. So what's the fasim in the derasechem? Must be that while you're singing the sukkah, you have to engage you yourself. It has to be kavana, as the Bach says over there, that this is the only mitzvah besides children, that the kavana of the sukkah is part of the mitzvah. To know why you're singing a sukkah. And all those who disagree with the rabbi, because they hold that it's a nani covered, and then take the pasuk of shutta. The man here say him is tell your children. So that's what seems to Rashi, how he learns. Why could Abzei Namle Amri? Why don't you say that Ahuli, Yemaisa, Mashiach? See, if that's a promise in the future that sukkah teal, etzel, yemim, that sukkah the Mashiach will come, will be there to provide shade. And Nur Abzeda Hakatake is talking about loss of love and Mashiach will come. How can he use it for the Yom Tov Sukkot? The Imkei Lemakrav Chupatil Etzel Yemim. If all we're talking about is that we're going to live in, you know, we're going to be have a shade all that time Mashiach, why use the word Sukkot, which is a word we only use for a mitzvah? My Sukkot is a Yom Shalom Neitarti. Once the Mashiach will come, and the other one, that when Mashiach will come, the Sukkot will protect us from the sun and everything else. But also teaching the mitzvah Sukkot comes out. A very important piece of Gemara, which is very difficult to be negated. Gemara of Chesed and Beis, we'll learn later, and Halacha. So Gemara clearly says here the reason why they don't agree with Rav Zeidi is because they believe that pasuk, the Sukkah Tiel Etzel Yom, is talking about the Yemais Mashiach, nothing to do with the mitzvah of Sukkah. Okay, Rav Zeidi holds it also both. Yet in the Chesed and Beis, we learn, and it's Rosh Hashanah, that when you build a Sukkah, the only kavana you need to have is that this Sukkah is provided shade. That's the mitzvah of building a Sukkah. And Gemara clearly says over here, but Rashi burns. Rashi says, the Yemaisim Sheikh, Oisim Sukkahs Yil Etzel. Those Sukkahs in the time of Yil Etzel. Abo Sukkahs Mitzah Ein Etzel. Clear. And we don't paskin like I've said. So how in the world do we paskin that a Sukkah has to be Yil Etzel? We'll see in the Chesed Beis, the different Sukkahs, the Rav Kash, all the different Sukkahs there. What kind of Sukkah to build? A Sukkah that can generate shade. But it says clearly that's not what you have to have in mind. As we'll see later in the Gemara. So you might write, okay, so that's a bit later. Kerov and Amal Amri.
Yes. say some shen. That's the whole thing to be simple. Some shen is the kind.
No, we'll see later on. Sukkah's royim, a sukkah that shepherds build, a sukkah's noshim, they did not have a mind in Yom Tov. But if they build that sukkah to provide them shade, not to use the bamboo, give them discretion, but if they did it to build them, protecting the sun, it's kosher for sukkahs. Because that's the only criteria. Well, who shall see you let's say? How does that fit into the Gemara right here? The way it actually lives. But anyway, taking it further. Why did all the grub the lechayde one of the high and 20 amos has to be said that is because that did us adai which will push the buyer because the buyer is questioned. It's because of the question of a buyer. Why? Because the buyer asked the question on rubber that how can you say did us kevers if I build a wall out of metal is that a problem? And then rubber gave an answer and rubber's answer is not that compelling. Abayah also has a question of Zeta as well, but Zeta gave us a good answer. Remove Dalas's Kanai, remove the mountains from there, everything will be all right. Tell your mother, so master, we have a few, but I so we have three different possible explanations as why a Sukkah Lamayla Machav Amma is possible. We're going to have three different opinions on what the Rav said. So who does it follow? What Rabbi Yeshua made a name that I would follow. He made this following comment. The whole machlekes is when the walls will not reach the schach. If the walls of the sukkah actually reach the schach, even higher than 10, 20 amos kosher. What possible logic is that? Which of the three reasons that make sense on? Only command can Rabbi. What does Rabbi say? Because you don't look up at the schach. But if the walls come and are contiguous to the schach, your eyes travel along the walls and you'll come across the schach. If the walls stop short from the schach, then you won't continue going high, then where the wall ends. The key to the problem is schach, and eventually shoulder, but since the walls reach the schach, then you will see the schach. Okay. So that's the issue, Rabbi. Lechi is a post.
Yes, I'm sorry.
You don't need both, only one. No. Well, what do you need the credit for? Have Lechi. Yeah, but if you may, the problem with Yams is only with a credit. But if you have a Lechi, that's it. 10 fucking high. What do you need a credit for? So that's Rabbi Yeshua's comment. So Rabbi Yeshua understood that Rab follows Rab. Comes on the next Talmud. Come on, hold on, Rab. Who knows Rab? Who knows the name of Rab? Machleke. So they all argue with what Rab holds. Machleke is b'shem b'lar b'lar b'lar. The sukkah is only 4x4. Abul yesh b'lar yeshu b'lar b'lar. The sukkah is much wider than the 4x4. I feel the ma'ila mesher amishah. Even if the schach is above 20 amas of kosher, that would that go kosher? That lechayda follows up Zayda. Abdeda says you don't get shade from the schach, you're getting shade from the walls. But if it's a wider sukkah, you will get some shade from the schach. So I'm going to be some tzelu, because the shade, but keep the levicha, because the sukkah is wider, he could sell sukkah. Follow the shade of sukkah. So according to Rav Huna's version of Rav follows Abdeda. Tesha already asks, but what happened to the sukkah is 40 amas high, and the sukkah is 5 amas wide, is that going to work? So Tesha's first answer is it's all proportional. So the proportion of 4 amas to 20, so you work your way out, higher and wider. The second answer is no. Even if it's 40 amas tall, as if it's 4 amas and a bit, it's already good enough. And he based it on the Gemara we just learned in Yuma, where the Gemara says over there that a kosevis calms you down, even if you're the size of Oyge Melech HaBoshon, because we say that, okay, for a normal person, it's miyashiv you a lot, for Oyge miyashiv you a little bit, but something's going to happen, a modicum. So same thing over here. Even though the shade, If it's a little bit wider than 4 amas, it's going to be minuscule, but it'll be something, and that's enough. Third, amoyda. Come on, Ozo, Adam, Rav, Chonam, Barab, Omar, Rav, Machlekes, B'she'enim, Machzekes, Elekedei, Reishay, Verub, V'she'chonim. Machlekes is only if the sukkah is large enough, which is very small, to fit your head and most of your body and part of your and your table. Which we'll see 7 tefachim. Ava machzek is yoisim mechdei roishim b'ru v'shachadim. But if the sukkah is wider than 7 tefachim, then I feel the mailim esim amak shayla, even higher than 20 amas kosher. Now, come on, who does that go going to? It doesn't nothing to do with why would you see the schach going to rabba? Why it's not it's above 20 amas going to rabba? It's still keva. And even according to Rabbi Zayde, because the shade, if it's only 7 tefachim, why you're not going to see the shade if it's higher than 20 amas? Command the like a chat must be another whole reason. To the basis of the 20 amas, and if it's wider than 7 tefachim, that reason is eliminated. We don't know what that reason is. So there's actually a fourth reason in our Gemara, we just know what it is. Said Gemara. They talk about the width of the sukkah and the dimension of the sukkah. He's not talking about the dimension of the sukkah. All he's talking about is if the walls reach the schach or they don't reach the schach. Rav Huna and Rav Chana bar Abba. Rav Huna and Rav Chana bar Abba are saying basically the same thing, but they're just giving different dimensions. One of them says 4 amas. If the sukkah is wider than 4 amas, then it could be higher than 20. Another one says if it's 7 tvachim. Reishav Ruba Meshachan is 7 tvachim. If it's wider than that, it's all right. What are they arguing about? Name of Lechayda, they're arguing about Basunsi and Tamar Gemara. Machlek is Behechsha Sukkah. What's the minimum size of Sukkah? Because Rebbe holds the minimum size of Sukkah is 4 amas by 4 amas. A house is not less than 4 amas by 4 amas. And then we have the Chan and Chacham, hold that 7 tvachim by 7 tvachim. Lechayda, that's the Machlek is between Rav Huna and Rav Chana bar Abba. Rav Huna says 4 amas, and Rav Chana bar Abba holds like Rebbe. And Rav Chana bar Abba holds no, the minimum size of Sukkah is 7 by 7. That the minimum size of a sukkah can hold your head and your most of your body and say what's in it. See, we're lining up. Kuliam, everyone holds Heksha sukkah is a reshiva rube vashachani. Everyone holds that the minimum size of a sukkah is your head, your most of your body, and the table. So how come he says 4 amas? Over here, but how come he? Marsava the marzek is reishivu ruvishachonei pligi. The argument is only if it contains 7 tanakama and abiyuda that higher than 20 amas as possible is only the sukkah is the bare minimum 7 tvach. Abul yoyit. They're not arguing about the dimensions of a kosher sukkah. They're arguing about the dimensions of a kosher sukkah vis-a-vis the shade of the schach. So he holds only the sukkah is exactly 7 tvachim. Then a problem with the shade, and that's what have a machlekes of the Chachamim and Rabbi Yehuda. The table is wider than that. Divrei Hakol Kshera. Everyone holds kosher, but we don't know why, because there's another reason why they're arguing. We just don't know what that reason is. Well, mass of them, and the other one holds. The one holds Mereishiv Rubu Shachani. Adal Amos Pligi. You will not get shade from the schach. Because you follow Zaydi, you won't get shade from the schach if the sukkah is less than 4 amas wide, even though the sukkah is kosher 7 tvachim a bit. But the shade is a problem, even 2 amas, 3 amas, up to 4 amas. Aval yoyisim b'dal amas, if the sukkah is wider than 4 amas, then even hakuk shade, everyone's kosher. Meitzel asks a question. It says sukkah shigavim asim amas p'sula. Rabbi Yehuda machshir a sukkah which is higher than 20 amas is possible. Rabbi Yehuda says kosher adad boim v'chamishim amas up to 40-50 amas. Oh, Rabbi Yehuda, and the market continues. Rabbi Yehuda brings support to support his proof. He said to support his opinion. He says, Rabbi Yehuda says, Maisid is a story by Heloni Amalka. There's a story about Heloni Amalka, Belut, in the city of Lut. Shahoisa Sukosa Gavoya Me'esim Amma, her sukkah was taller than 20 Amos. Well, Yeskainim Nechnasim Yeitim Lasham, she was frequented by all these Talmudic scholars. And her sukkah was higher than 20 Amos, and no one said to her, Heloni, this is not a kosher sukkah. So as I said, Rabbi Yehuda used that as support, approved that one, that is kosher. Omru loy, so that the Chachamim said back to Rabbi Yehuda, v'sham raya, isha ha'isa, she said, well, anyway, put him in a sukkah. It doesn't matter if it's kosher. The reason why they said nothing is, so what's a pasul sukkah? Why tell her anything? A woman, even if she's pasul sukkah, if she wants to take on the mitzvah, she can, and she makes a bracha. Maybe they knew that she did make a bracha. Amalan, so he said back to there, he said back to there, I'll taste a good day. You know why? I'm not really worried about Heloni Malka. What about the children? Well, the Shiva, but you know, they had 7 sons and they needed a sukkah, peace with the Rabban. So the Chacham would have said, hey, you should have, but I call Marcel also a picha chum and everything she did, she followed chum. What's his voice adding? What's that coming to add? I'm using that as a second proof. What's that adding? Call Marcel also a picha chum. This is what he said. You can tell me why they were young little, so they were tiny tats. That's why Chacham said nothing. We'll learn later the criteria for a child for chinuch. If he no longer needs his mother, he's chayiv mitzvah chinuch of a sukkah. So there were definitely 7 kids. Some of them would have been chayiv and chinuch. Chacham would have said something. This is a famous machlekes from Agadim. Others, the Mishnah Berurah talks about in Tafrei Nun Ches, and the machlekes is. You know, we have a shayla, a lulav. We'll see that you're learning more of a lulav. How do you give it to a kid? Because your kid is kinder, but he cannot give it back. And nobody's allowed to use a bar lulav the first 2 days of Yom Tov. So the question is, so what's the big deal? Give the kid the lulav. So what is borrowed? Is the mitzvah chinuch the general idea to go through the mitzvah? Does it matter? The pitchiklach, the protim are exact? Or no, the mitzvah chinuch is that the only way the child can be yetzer the mitzvah is if had this child been a god, we'll also be yetzer. That's an expression where a chagiga did design. That, you know, if he gets old, well, if he gets older as a child, he will become, you know, that's how we do it. It's talking about a chigir over there. a kid who's limping is part of a prisoner's limping is part of, and a kid also, because if he would have been older, he'd also be in this situation part of. Anyway, so it's a mission the reason machlekes, and here we see clearly from here that when the Gemara says clearly that they don't bring this as a raya, but chayit is clear here is when you have the mitzvah of chinuch, it has to be 100%. Otherwise, the Gemara could have answered, oh, yeah, of course, that's chinuch of sukkah. So what if the sukkah wasn't built was properly over 20 amas? So what? I know that you can argue back. There's a difference between a borrowed sukkah lulav and this. A borrowed lulav is a prat in the mitzvah. The mitzvah is to take a lulav and to be yaitzah. Then you have, you know, these side dinim. Here, this is the sukkah. Remember, the sukkah is the schach. If the schach is above 20 amas, it's not a sukkah. It's not a side issue here. This is the issue. So therefore, even if you hold chinuch, is not every detail of all the minutia, but this is not a minutia. This is the din of sukkah. Maybe that's how we can defend the prima godin. Taking it further. The chi same, you can tell me, maybe it's only chayim drabbanon, v'i b'drabbanon, if you didn't care, toshma, v'oi kol ma'aseh l'osa el ha'pichachamim. I told you last week, the place is shown in Yuma, the pay base, talks about that the mitzvah chinuch is not on the mother, the mitzvah chinuch is on the father, and also by the daughter. And he asks a question, what's shutting about here? So either he says, Helen Malka had a husband, but she was a dominant figure, and therefore we don't even know about a husband, or she only did it not as a chiv, she did it as a mitzvah chinuch, not that she's chayiv in chinuch, but she's still doing a mitzvah. Tell you what. So this is the conversation between Rabbi Yehuda and Chachamim. Let's see Rabbi Yehuda. Bish leil madam shein chamim gilas chach machlekes. If you tell me the whole argument is between the Chachamim and Rabbi Yehuda is when the walls do not reach the chach, whether you are yaitzeh or not yaitzeh. Okay, Hilani Malka, for example, they used to make sure the walls didn't reach the chach so it can be fresh air. Remember, it's sukkah time in Israel, you have fresh air. Tach is darka shemalka leishem sukkah ain't fanim megilas chach. It's common for a queen or for an aristocrat not to, call Helani Amalka, I'm not sure exactly who she is, but that aristocrat doesn't, wall reaching the sukkah. So this is Mamish the Machlekes. And he used it to prove to himself. You see, the wall didn't reach his chach, and yet they say that Helani Amalka sat there, nobody said a word to her. B'shem Avira to have ear. The whole Machlekes, if it's 7 tefachim, but if it's wider, or 4 amas even. But if it's wider than 4 amas, then the shade is all right. Everyone is moided, that is kosher. So what's the eye from the Bechidaka Shemalka Leish Mezukitana? You think she sat in the sukkah less than 4 amas wide? Maybe she has a whole entourage with her. She doesn't sit alone. She's a makeup lady, and a person, and a butler. And they're all there to serve her. So the servicer. So how can, So what's the eye from here? We're talking about a sukkah, hasuya, kitainis. There's one main big room, the sukkah. Then you have a bunch of little ancillary rooms that come off that abut this bigger sukkah. And she sat in one of those little rooms. And therefore, tak it small. And Rashi says these little rooms. Maybe the door was open, they could talk to her. That room was, as Rashi says, with Sinusa. Can you imagine Hilani Amalka? All these rabbis went to visit her, and still she was so discreet. She sat in a little closet like room, less than 4 amas. Put sinusa the alma. So that katanius was puzzle. It didn't matter. She's a woman. The kids were all in the main sukkah. You think all the rooms are little tiny rooms. It was a big sukkah, and the kids had a big sukkah. There was also a couple of little ancillary rooms, and that's where she sat. The kid sat in the proper sukkah, therefore the chacham didn't say anything. It's only her, and she has no mitzvah. Why should I tell her anything? She sat there because of tznius, even though they all went to visit her. Even though there's a small little room, the kids like their mother, they're young, and they used to hang around her. Nobody said, hey, your children are with you, they're eating something, you should send them into the main sukkah. If that's the idea, we'll stop here.